Good stories, need I say, surprise, and because of this, they teach. But the promise of learning that comes with surprise is only the necessary, not sufficient condition that makes a story stick. Besides teaching, memorable stories use formulas and recipes to work their magic. The 1001 Nights or Arabian Tales are immortal because they use patterns of storytelling very effectively. One of the most effective is the story within a story. 1001 Nights is one long framing story. A king discovers that his wife is unfaithful. Convinced that he is doomed to suffer the same indignity again, he vows to marry a new woman every night, but only for one night, so that she does not have the chance to be unfaithful. After a while, the prime minister can no longer find eligible maidens. His job and head are at stake. To his horror, his daughter, Scheherazade, volunteers. But every night, Scheherazade begins telling the story without finishing it. The king, wanting to know the ending, extends his marriage one night at a time. And so begins the cycle of stories that the king and audience listen to for 1001 nights. You see, stories within stories move well because while you kind of know what the end will be, you do not really know it until the end. Furthermore, each story builds on the expectations of the previous one, in terms of plot and climax, feeding the curiosity of the listener. It is a little bit like the animated series Scooby-Doo, where the mystery is the same, only the situation different. Another narrative plot that always works is that of the reversal of fortune. For example, the first story Scheherazade tells is that of the merchant and the genie. In it, a merchant accidentally kills a genie's invisible son by tossing away the pit of a date. The genie, enraged, appears before the merchant and vows to kill him for his mistake. The merchant, terrified, pleads to be given 1 year to say goodbye to his family. The genie agrees. Dutifully, after a year, the merchant returns. But as he is approaching the fateful reunion, he comes across three wise men. Upon hearing his misfortune, the three men offer to help. When the genie shows up, they each ask to tell a story, and if the genie likes it, to forgive one-third of the man's sin. They do, each story showing how the narrator has been deceived or tricked by through mercy found justice. Finally, the merchant is forgiven. Reversal of fortune works very well because there's always an expectation that something should happen because everything has gone so bad for our main character. There is, in other words, an expectation that our expectations will be violated. These are just two storytelling patterns that could be employed to sustain a good story. As the Arabian Nights show, there are many others: identification of the reader with the main character, a sense of justice, comedic elements, or characters that prove to be someone else than they say, to name a few. Journalists use serialization and reversal of fortune often, thus data stories can make that same point too. Take another look at the Arabian Nights. You will learn a lot about making good stories. After all, stories saved Scheherazade's life.